If there is one issue that Arjuna seems to be having on the battlefield, or we generally in life, is the ability to discriminate between right and wrong. Now here's where Krishna comes in with the theory of how perception discriminates the difference between right and wrong. What is the definition of perception? Perception refers to the ability to gather sensory information to understand better about the environment and the situation that we are living in. Now these are the same in how we develop and use our sensory organs in our day-to-day life. When the light hits the retina of the eye, it generates vision. When we are able to feel the odor molecules, we generate smell. And at the same time, when we are able to hear the pressure waves of sound from a distance, we are able to generate the sound organ, which is the hearing sense. Now all these five sense organs, such as sight, sound, touch, taste, smell, all these things happen in our perception without our conscious awareness. These things happen subconsciously. So our consciousness is not even involved in these five basic sense organs that we use on a day-to-day basis. But the way we approach our other senses is completely different. That is where we either become sense or we either become senseless. So this is the main aspect that Krishna is trying to say by talking about discriminating right and wrong. And for this, there is a theory by Alan Sachs and Gary Johns. These two people said that there are three main components of perception, starting with the perceiver. Now the person who perceives a particular information in their day-to-day life has three central stages on how they perceive information. It depends on their emotional state, on their motivational state, and also about their experience in that subject or life in general. Now, if these three states are imbalanced, like if you're very high on motivation, there are chances where you would pick certain information very quickly or grasp it much, much faster than a person who has a low motivation state. Now, if you're very sensitive in terms of your emotion and if you're very emotional in nature as a person, there are some information that you would not take it well and some you would take it straight to heart and it might hurt you or it might make you feel really good. It would be like everybody is a Punjabi when you have an high emotional state. And also, when you are high on experience in certain things, the way you perceive certain things would be in a much matured manner than someone with lack of experience. Now, as I said in one of my earlier videos, experience is the first step towards gaining wisdom. So a more experienced person is much likely to perceive the difference between right and wrong better than a person who does not have experience. Now the second stage of perception is target. The person who says the perception of information. Now you take someone who's talking a particular thing to us. We always look at the person who's talking rather than the message what is being spoken. You know, you take Krishna himself to be an example. How many of us follow Krishna and how many of us follow the message that Krishna says? There will definitely be a lot of people who are in the first category who follow Krishna, but very few who follow Krishna's message. They might not worship Krishna, they might not prostrate before Krishna, but they will make their entire life by following Krishna's teachings. Now you tell me, which one is more superior, following a person or following the message of a person? So the target makes a lot of difference in how we perceive information, and scientifically it is known as sense of agency. Now this particular sense of agency is how, without sometimes we ourselves knowing, we are able to perceive a certain information. Like normally we wouldn't have done that, normally we wouldn't have understood that really good, but without we ourselves knowing, we got it in and out. Sometimes if we have a friend who's teaching us max, we would be able to understand it pretty quickly than a teacher who's teaching it. And that is why that can be used even on a righteous cause as well. Sometimes, like, take someone like Usain Bolt, for example. In one of his winning speeches, he told that my power of visualization is something where before running the race itself, I knew that this is going to be the finish. So without knowing himself, he subconsciously realized that he is going to win that race. And that is the sense of agency. Now the third and final stage of perception is situation. Now the situation can be contributed by many social factors, which in our perception can be called as social cognition. Now these depend on the society that we grew up in, the society that we live in, and more importantly, a ton of environmental factors. If as a society we are a sensitive society, there are certain things that we can't talk openly or in a public forum. And if you're living in a very open society, there are some things which we can talk without any consequences, but would be respected for coming out and using their freedom of speech. So these things depend solely on the experience and, more importantly, the society that we live in. So with these three important stages, we would be able to understand on how we perceive a particular information. Now for that, I'll give you a very small and quick example. Now, from the start of my Bhagavad Gita series, I would have told you a lot of examples. I would have told about Hitler. I would have told about Dhoni. Now, a lot of people would have told me, how can you compare Hitler with Bhagavad Gita? That doesn't seem to add up. But here, the one thing that we need to understand is, I'm not talking about Hitler the person, but rather I'm talking about the work that Hitler did as a person. That negative trait could be matched with that of what Duryodhana did on the battlefield. And that was what was collated and given as an example. Now, if we perceive it in a different way, there is no right or wrong in perception. That is one thing that we have to understand. There is no right or wrong in perception. That is what even Krishna says to Arjuna on the battlefield. But what we need to do is to realize how we have to be stable in all the other factors that induce our perception. Because we cannot control perception itself. It is an automatic process. But what we have in hand is how we can work towards the road of perception. If our emotional state is balanced, if our motivational state is in check, and more importantly, if we learn new things by experience, then we are able to develop the proper sense of perception where we would be able to attain the right knowledge and the right information through the process of perception. And that is what Krishna says to Arjuna in this verse, to discriminate the difference between right and wrong in life in general. And for that, the first thing that we need to do is just free our mind, and it will always lead the way. Now that's a wrap for this particular episode, and as always, thank you for watching, and until the next time, it is goodbye.